Hey y'all, it's your girl Erica Bean back with another video talking about the power universe. Well, in this video in particular, I am going to go into the IG live that Courtney Kemp did on her own personal IG, as well as conversation that Omari Hardwood had on the Higher Learning podcast, because they both talked about ghosts, talked about his story, talked about his death, and they kind of don't agree. So I wanted to make a video where I'm able to put both of the things that are said from each party and we can really dissect it and jump into it. If you are a power fan like me, you probably are still struggling with the fact that Ghost is dead and what happens next, but also enjoying all the amazing content that has come our way by way of the new spinoff. So Power Book 2 Ghost is exceptional. Power Book 3 Raising Kanan is coming soon, and I'm sure it's exceptional as well. But let me stop with this introduction and get into this video, honey. Okay, so as I was saying, if you're like me, you miss Ghost. We miss Power. Yes, that is clear. But you also came to a very pleasant surprise after watching Power Book 2 Ghost, because Tariq is bringing it. That show is great. It keeps the power flow going, but with a little extra twist. And now this summer, we're getting Raising Kanan on July 18th. It's going to premiere with this first season. And we will also be getting this year Power Book 4 Force, which is Tommy's spinoff. So while many of us are still missing Ghost, we are also still enjoying very much the content that is still coming out of the Power universe as it expands, as it grows, and we get new characters, but also get to drop in with some of the characters that we have grown to know and love, or in terms of Tariq, have learned to hate and now love, because he's turned his life around, kinda sorta. You know what I mean? This video ain't about that, but you know. So the first thing that I really want to talk about is Courtney Kemp saying that they had to kill Ghost, and this is what she had to say on her live.
People are always like, why did you kill Ghost? A ghost shouldn't be dead, and all these different pieces. And for me, it was that story was kind of over in that sense, where that story was ending. And also, we promised very early that Ghost was going to end up either dead or in jail. I mean, I think we really addressed that. That doesn't mean that, you know, there aren't other ways of telling that story. Certainly.
And then a little bit later on in her life, she also goes to talk about the amount of story that she felt like Power had, and specifically saying that she felt like there was only really 5 seasons worth of Power story to tell. But I'm gonna let her tell you.
I just felt like there was only 5 years of that story to tell. And then we did get convinced to do a 6th season, and I didn't have so much more story to tell in a way that would have kept that pace and that excitement and that drive that we'd given the audience. I mean, we can definitely limp on into like being bad TV. That's always an option, especially when you have a hit. You can just make season after season of not that great drama. You know what I mean? Like, Angela was dead at the end of season 5, so your core love triangle's gone. You know, Tariq is becoming a man, so that's a different story. You know, there were just the stories that we would have had to tell and shift going forward would have had a different center. And so it wouldn't have been Power as the fans experience it.
And this is where I disagree. And Omari Hardwick, who is the actor who plays Ghost in the Power amazing breakout stars hit, he disagrees as well. In an interview with Higher Learning, he goes on to talk about how we really don't know Ghost. We never got to know Ghost, and that's part of why he believes the fans are having a very hard time with letting him go. Take a listen.
If the producers, you know, wanted me to come back and be able to be that which I did not complete, and that being the telling of Ghost's story a little bit more, not necessarily from Tasha and the kids and Tommy forward, but we don't really know who Ghost was behind. And so what I think the fans are upset about, without absolutely knowing that they're upset, some of them know, but it's not an absolution in their brain. They're upset because we never flushed Ghost out. I played the guy, so nobody could say it like me. I still don't really know the dude, because I didn't get to activate the parts of him prior. And all the spinoffs are those actors activating the parts prior to what their characters were. But what about Ghost? He's the epicenter of the show. We don't really know dude.
He even goes as far as to say specifically what we don't know about Ghost, mainly talking about what about him before Tasha and the kids, before the major suit wearing, Dapper Dan trying to go good, that we see in Power, how did he actually get there? Which is something that I brought up in my video where we're talking about her updates from Courtney Kemp's updates from her live, because that's basically what Raising Kanan is going to be. Raising Kanan is going to be the story of how Kanan became Kanan. And Omari really brings up a valid point in saying that we don't know much about Ghost. We aren't getting all of those details. We're getting the details about Kanan. We have more details about Tommy, but we don't have those details about the person who the show is centered around. But let me let y'all listen to exactly what Omari said.
The guy that is, I don't know, 22, 25 and back, that would include meeting Tasha, include meeting Tommy, meeting Kanan, that the fans never got to know. You don't really know anything about Ghost. He really was a ghost when you really think about it. Tommy had a father. All of a sudden, the father was introduced. Tommy has a drugged out mother. We already knew her. Tasha has a mom, beautifully played by the great actress. We had kids, but that's we having kids at Ghost now. Ghost and Kanan had a relationship, but what did it smell like when they were teenagers? What did Ghost and his father rock out with when the mom left? There's nothing but insinuation to what Ghost was. We don't really know.
Overall, Omari said that he would definitely be open to returning to Power or any of the spinoffs and being able to provide some type of leverage to the characters. Maybe his namesake of Ghost actually becomes just that. Check it out.
Hell, you name the guy Ghost, and so there's always to me a possibility of being just that. Since we're on the board of zombie, you're not actually going against the subject. He really lives in a ghost space at this point. So now that we know he's not on Earth, there is a reality where you could have flashbacks. No, I don't really know why you would need spinoffs if Omari was still a part of the original. The original is the original. Spinoffs are just that, spinoffs. So I would come back, but perhaps in the spinoffs just as a space to sort of give leverage to the show to go, okay, Ghost is now speaking to Tariq, but we know he's not actually there. Okay, Ghost in Tommy's head, but is he really there? You know, leaving that mystique there, but I'd always be open. It changed my life. The show changed my life.
Courtney also addressed on her live that she would not be interested in doing a prequel for Tommy and Ghost. So even though Omari would love to see that happen, it probably will not happen. She said,
but if you're talking about a show that's about like young Ghost and Tommy, I've addressed that already. I'm not interested in that show. Again, and I'll tell you guys why. As a writer, this is just writers now, you know that Ghost and Tommy survived that. So it's hard to put stakes into their stories. It's just more difficult.
Now, while she can't see herself doing a prequel with Tommy and Ghost, it sounds like she's kind of open to the idea of Ghost appearing in any of the spinoffs. And it makes sense for him to show up in Tommy or Tariq's ear and be a ghost and maybe haunt them a little bit or give them advice on their new endeavors. Tariq is at Stansfield building his own drug empire. Tommy has had to relocate after returning and popping up in Power Book 2 Ghosts and deciding to leave New York. He still has a bullet with Tasha's name on it, but for now, he's going to put that on hold and he's headed out west. You know, this has all happened right after Ghost's death, so we could definitely see either of them start to spiral a little bit and start to manifest or see ghosts appear as they are moving through their lives as they move forward, because he's definitely had a huge impact and influence on them. When asked about doing a Power season 7, Courtney had this to say.
The version of going back to the Power story that I would do is almost impossible just contractually, because I would need to get so many people paid, but I would love to do it. I mean, there'd be so great. I think, you know, I don't want to say which characters, but yeah, there's a couple that I would love to do. That I would love to do like a movie version where people were, you know, back.
All right, y'all, that is my breakdown and comparison around Courtney Kemp and Omari Hardwick's conversation around the character Ghost most recently. I just wanted to do this video, honestly, because I was watching both of the live as well as the interview. And while it seemed like they're not on the same accord with some things they do seem like they're on the same accord with. Honestly, I think that maybe in a year or two, we could potentially see them team up again. We could potentially see Ghost in some capacity. The way that the series have been written, the way they have operated, is they kind of left themselves a back door if they ever wanted to open this world back up, if they ever wanted to have this character re-enter the Powerverse and be something of importance, then they could definitely do that with how they left everything off. Both of these interviews just kind of confirmed for me Omari is interested in still telling Ghost's story. Courtney, as a writer, has certain restrictions that she doesn't want to go into or things that she doesn't want to touch upon, but she's still open to being creative. And if a creative idea arises in the next year or two, I think that she would definitely explore it if it is something that could be game changing, something that could be Power Universe changing and exciting and innovative. She would definitely be down to do it, and we would all love to see it. I don't think any of the Power fans are going anywhere. Power is definitely a breakout hit show that we all fell in love with almost immediately, and we will be waiting for years for more content, and we can't get enough of any of the stuff that they give us. Now it's your turn. Jump down to the comment section down below and tell me what you thought of both of these interviews. I'll also have the IG Live and Omari's interview linked in the description box down below if you want to watch the full thing. Omari was on this podcast promoting his new Netflix film, which is a zombie movie, very different from how we have seen him. And Courtney just hopped on her IG Live for about 30 minutes to talk mainly about advice for writers, but then gave us some Power updates, just so that you have the context of both of these videos. If you're new here, I'm Erica Vane, and I post new entertainment videos every day, multiple times a day. I'm covering your favorite series. I'm telling you which films are the bomb that you gotta watch, as well as keeping you up on entertainment news. And you should really join the tribe by hitting subscribe. I promise you're going to love it here. If you're looking for a new series to watch, I have a few suggestions for you right here. So go ahead and tap, tap, tap in. I'll see you in my next video. Bye.